All right, Will Robertson, of course, Acting Up and ActingUpRadio.com. Brought to you by allcasting and allcasting.com. If you need a profile or you need to get leads on auditions, go to allcasting.com. So this week, as you're watching the show, the cool thing is that you notice that we have this new format. And the new format is that we are doing split-screen Skype. So if you are just listening to this, you're kind of being robbed because my guest is on the line. You can see him. He's in the wings. I just don't have curtains for the wings right now. And he's a gentleman by the name of Austin that I've known for quite some time, mainly because of some of the cowboy work he does. But Austin, welcome to the show.
Hey, thanks for having me.
Yeah, I'm excited. So I want to start off, first of all, by we're going to give your information about where to get a hold of you and everything. But do you technically say your name is Bachman? How do you say it, your last name?
Buchanan.
See? I did this last time I spoke to you. I know your first name, and that's the most important thing. If you can, if you're talking to someone, you call them a friend, you don't know their first name, you're in trouble. Second name, so it's Buchanan. Austin, yes. Buchanan. All right. Now, if you want to check out Austin's information, because he will be the spotlight person on the show today, you can check it out at Austin_Bachman. I'm sorry, Buchanan. Keep saying it. I'm going to spell it so you know. That's Instagram. And I always like to give that first. It's Austin, A-U-S-T-I-N, _ B-U-C-H-A-N-A-N. And if you're spelling that out, you're like, dude, Will, that's already pretty obvious. Anyway, Austin Buchanan. And you are technically right now, you are in, not in Phoenix, but you're in Tucson, correct?
Yes. Yeah, I'm in Tucson, Arizona.
Now, you came, you were in L.A. for quite some time, weren't you?
Yeah, I moved there, and things were going well, and then pretty much just expenses. I was, I'd say the mistake I made was that I was living with a girlfriend.
Oh!
And then...
Enough said.
That happens.
Yeah. No, so, and the statement you made about expenses, I think you meant to say L.A. is expensive.
Yes, and Tucson is like one of the cheapest places to live.
It is definitely the cheapest place to live, and you definitely don't need to have any heat during the summer because there's plenty of it.
Yeah, definitely AC. You need AC.
You need AC. But here's one cool thing is that because you are in Tucson, you are literally a hop, skip, and a bump away from probably one of the most iconic film location sets, and that's Old Tucson, so that's kind of cool.
Yeah, actually, I worked at Old Tucson for 10 years, and that's kind of how I got my start in things and kind of reflamed the acting.
Right. So that brings me to the first question, which is, by the way, just to let you know, Austin was one of our winners for the contest we had during the Super Bowl, and he did a great monologue, and you can probably surf through a lot of our stuff. By the way, if you go to allcasting on YouTube, you can check out some of the stuff that we have done there, and in addition, you can see Austin's piece that he did. So the first question, the obvious one, is... how'd you start? Because I know you're also quite an accomplished, I'll say illustrator, but graphic artist as well, correct?
Right, yeah. How did I start? That's a big question.
Well, little answers are okay.
Well, like I was acting when I was younger, always in school and things like that. And throughout high school, I was always in the plays. And then when it came to college, I kind of put that aside and started doing graphic design and art. And I've always been to art my whole life. But then I started working back at Old Tucson, and it re-sparked the fire of acting.
Yeah.
I would always make YouTube videos. I used to make the YouTube videos and vlogs and little skits here and there. And then filmmaking became more professional for me. And I started taking my time with shots and wanting to be in front of the camera. And then... Yeah, I'd say Old Tucson is a huge factor in getting me started in the film world.
Right. Well, I'll tell you, and I'm going to give you a little compliment here, that in this day and age, it's really kind of hard to find what I would guess you would call almost a Renaissance man or woman, in the sense that, you know, there's a lot of people out there that say, I want to be an actor, and I'm just going to be an actor, and they don't understand that there's a lot of other things that you should understand. Production, graphics, the business parts of it, and getting in there and getting maybe not necessarily your acting chops, but maybe stunts or maybe, you know, production parts of it. Or as you do, you also are a teacher that works at a really very, I would say, a very progressive studio in Tucson, which is called
Film Actor Workshops.
And I did a seminar there on, what do you call it, actors, social media. And I was totally blown away by the fact that you all had a lot of very dedicated people. And so I say to you that, yeah, I'm not surprised that you were able to start with perhaps Old Tucson Studios, because you're a good cowboy too. but, you know, but you're one of those actors that I would say is smart, that you learn a lot of different things. And now you're also helping, and I guess what's the term, giving back or paying forward, because you're helping other actors try to achieve their goals.
Right. Yeah. And I think that, you know, it's really important that that you do that, because it's not, as much as it is like a dog eat dog kind of industry,
it is.
You do have to help people who want to know, because the information nowadays isn't free. It's always like, oh, buy this, buy this, buy this. And it's right. Like, oh man, like my class that I teach, the main one, mm-hmm. includes headshots, because I'm also a photographer.
Right.
And so, you know, they're getting a complete kind of head start in this class.
Head start.
We cover scene study, photos, auditioning, cold reads, monologues, and social media and networking for the second half of it.
Yeah.
And that's huge. Social media and networking is huge. It's unbelievably important.
I would say it's almost, I mean, when I talk about it, because I started 1981, and, you know, back then it was a lot different. I know you're not anywhere near my age, but, you know, back then we had black and white headshots. I talk about this all the time. And we just basically crossed our fingers and got an agent, and then we crossed our fingers that they would send us out. And there was very little control over what we were able to really achieve on our own. And the price points for getting any of these things done, whether it was shooting your own demo or you know, editing what you had, was really kind of off the charts, because they didn't have this that could do 4K. They basically, we just did what we could, and we would hope that, you know, cross our fingers, you would get to a level. But nowadays, like you said, the well-rounded actor has all those elements, yes?
Yeah, because you have to submit your own self-tapes and edit them, and it's going to look bad if you're like, okay, thank you, and like touching the camera.
Yeah.
So you trim off the beginning, trim off the end.
Right.
You got to have the right framing. Got to understand that lighting.
They're shooting like this, and their sound is like really, really bad. And you're going, and you can't see their face because it's shadowed, and they don't know where they're speaking. So, you know, it's really great. I always tell people nowadays, and I bet you'll confirm that this is true, is just that it's great to have acting experience. It truly is. But I will tell you that going out of the gate, if you really want to just get started as an actor, and we're saying this to all you all casting folks out there, commercials are probably one of the easiest, because you would be better off to have more special skills as a commercial actor than you would to be having Shakespeare under your belt, because it's about the look. And nowadays, quite honestly, I believe that a lot of acting is truly, one, about your social media, two, about your looks, and maybe lastly, they might even be interested in looking at your resume to see if you actually had any classes.
Yeah, I'd say classes are very important. Your special skills, your look, all that stuff, because, you know, I've even casted people just from looking at a photo they posted.
Yeah.
And I'm like, yes, that's
casting
exactly what
photo.
I want.
Yes.
With you, you did that commercial where you're dancing.
Yeah.
They wouldn't cast somebody who doesn't know how to dance. So it's those special skills really add up.
Absolutely. Yeah.
With us and our Western background.
Yeah.
I mean, how many Western roles I've gotten that I haven't auditioned for?
Yeah.
Because they're like, you can ride a horse, you can spin a gun,
you can
do a lasso, a whip.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's 100% more than most.
Sure. Well, you know, they don't want to, in any of the situations, any of the films I've done, they would rather have someone that actually knows how and is comfortable. Because you know as well as I do, if you folks watch any of the stuff that Austin's done, you can see it on his YouTube channel or on his website. By the way, if you go to his website, which is basically his name, Austin Buchanan, which is A-U-S-T-I-N, B-U-C-H-A-N-A-N.com, you can check out his site. By the way, it's a great website, and I'm jealous that his headshot looks so awesome. And I want him to do my headshot now. but the fact is that, you know, if you watch you in the, some of the stuff that you do, you'll see that there is a thing when an actor, and that's female or male, is comfortable in their genre or the time period. Like, how many times have you ever seen a guy? It's like watching a 16-year-old guy go to a prom. You look at them and you go, dude, someone should have told you how to wear that tuxedo, because it looks like it's falling off your body. Mm-hmm. And it's the same thing with the Western stuff. There's a way you move. There's a way you react with the six gun. There's a way that you act in the piece that keeps the genre and the time period alive. And you, by all means, have that. And it's not an easy thing to do. You have to do your 10 years of whatever.
Thank you. I appreciate that. I did do that, and I did a film recently where one of the actors didn't know guns. He's never shot a gun. He never did anything like that. And he was, like, throwing bullets every time he shot.
And that's a common thing. You know that's a common thing.
Every time you see it.
It's like this.
And it's like, I'm going to get you. And so, you know, you got to pull him aside and say, you know, you hold it still.
Regardless, you gotta, push it forward. It doesn't change the philosophy of the bullet.
Even with blanks, you know, there's a little kick on some of them.
There is, yeah.
And so it's just it's a thing you pick up, whether it is the Western genre or rom-com or whatever. Yeah, there's people who have a certain knack for something. It's like, that's pretty good. And don't be shy to show that.
Yeah, would you say as an actor, I know I have my genres or my types and my styles that I particularly wind up doing, but do you have one? And is this the one that you originally said, I'm going to be an actor and I want to be a superhero? Did you originally say to yourself, I see myself as this? Because it is important for an actor to look at themselves in the mirror and say, I'm a dad, or I'm a natural born killer, or I'm a funny guy. What was the original thing you thought of, and are you still holding to that as you get older?
So that I agree that 100% actors need to know their type. And it's not so much that you're going to typecast yourself, but as you see, like, people play these roles and they're very good at them.
Yeah.
And you should do that, especially when it gets into certain age ranges. It's like, well, you're going to play the sorority football hunk. Like, right? Yeah, it's just not, it doesn't match.
Yeah, thanks, Austin.
You're not in college.
What's that? Yeah.
So I think that is very important. For me,
being realistic,
I grew up doing impressions and comedy. And so I always thought, like, that was the knack.
Yeah.
But my getting my start at Old Tucson put me into the cowboy thing. And I learned that very well. And so I don't shy away from the cowboy thing, but I'm still, like, right now in Tucson, I'm trying to redo my reel so it has half modern, half Western.
Wow.
Because 80% of the things I've done have been Western. Or if they're modern day, it just wasn't enough meat for my reel.
Yeah.
And so now I'm like, okay, guys, I'll work for free. Come on, like, give me roles. Give me this, I need modern day stuff, just because I want a variety. I put myself in that category, and now I'm trying to just add a little variety in it.
You know, it's interesting you say that, because, you know, for the first, gee whiz, I've been doing this for 38 years, I would say the first probably 20 years easy, I was the Dick Van Dyke fall over the chair, stupid guy. I was the fall guy in British farce. I was always the one that was running around in his boxers, or, you know, the point is that I was the stupid guy, the idiot. And that was my deal, comedy, same as you're saying. Mm-hmm. And it's funny, maybe it's a cowboy thing, but the minute people started seeing the skills, which, by the way, recently, within the last 20 years, have really been when I developed a lot of those. was. And then all of a sudden I became, I mean, really, solidly in the last four or five films I've done, the guy who kills people. And it's like, wait a minute now, but I was really stupid. There's a great commercial I have called The Pocket Hose, where I'm spinning this thing and it's all stupid and I'm going, anyway, and I'm doing all this. And I'm like, they go, wow, that's very funny. I didn't know you did comedy. Really? And it's funny because, you know, you get caught into these genres or these styles, and because you are good with your gun, whips, whatever, and writing, it is something that will pigeonhole you. And Hollywood, quite honestly, so listen up, everybody, allcasting.com. By the way, look at the bottom of the screen. You can see the website, and you can see, of course, the social media. But the point is that Hollywood will easily typecast you if you let them do that. And so a lot of times, as you've said, I think we're pretty much, in essence, sort of mirrored, is that we try to break out of our what they might see us as, because you want to have variety and you want to have that that expansion, because otherwise that's all you'll do the rest of your life. And who? And no offense, but there's not enough cowboy gigs out there to do it all the time.
Yeah, you have a commercial here and there, and Westworld.
There you go.
And so, or like just independent shorts in Arizona is the biggest. Yeah. Arizona's Western. It's all they've always been that.
I know they have. Yeah.
Yeah, I agree, but it is hard to turn down those roles because you're good at it and you want to be good at it.
And it's fun.
You're good at it. Yeah, it's fun. Exactly.
I mean, you know, I will be honest with you and tell you, working at Old Tucson Studios and doing that film I did, which is called The West and the Ruthless, it's on Amazon, is pretty awesome to be able to say I did it. But, you know, it's kind of a, you know, you get locked into that and it's kind of difficult. So I got a couple of questions here that my group have asked me. If there's one single project that you can single out for best learning experience. So obviously we know that when we are working as actors, hopefully you have a self evaluating mechanism that allows you to learn, because some of us who don't have real formal education have learned on the job. And what is that for you? Is there a project you did that went, oh man, when I did this, I just learned so much? And what was it you learned?
So I did a movie. Okay, so this is a two-part answer.
Okay.
I did a movie called No Sunday West of Newton, and it was my first lead role in a movie.
Okay.
And I just wasn't as prepared as I thought.
Oh.
And it was such a slap in the face that everything after that, I was like, all right, I'm going to do my homework. I'm going to work. I'm going to do this. I'm going to do this. Even if it was a side role or whatever, supporting. It just, it really made me start taking it more serious because I just thought, like, oh, this is going to be a breeze. This is what I do.
I'll step in front of a camera and boom.
Yeah. And then, I mean, and that's also partially, it was an independent film. And so they didn't have everything, like, they weren't babysitting me.
Oh,
they weren't just like, oh, here's this and this
and
this. Yeah, we're doing this today. I hope you're ready. No, it was just like, show up at this time and I'm just supposed to be off book and know everything. And so that was a huge wake up call. And I started doing more TV shows and things. Legends and Lies, America, Fact versus Fiction, Deadly Shootouts. And all of those were, I don't know, it made me just solidify that I wanted to do this for a living.
Right. Well, it sounds like what your experience was, I got that you jumped into something and went, whoa, I'm just not where I thought I was. But more importantly, it sounds like it helped you understand that preparation, the actor prepares, is really kind of essential to walking into anything, whether it's one line or, you know, half the script or, you know, you're the lead in it, because there's a mindset that you obviously now know, and there's a process that every actor goes through to get ready for something, whether it's an audition or it's a role. But it sounds like that's what you gained out of it.
Yeah, 100%. It's so important that an actor puts in the work. If they don't, it shows. It really does.
It really does.
Whether it's in your career or just in the role you're playing, you have to put in the work. If you don't put in the work, then you're not taking yourself serious, and people aren't going to take you serious.
That's absolutely true. Okay, hey, so we're talking to Austin Buchanan, and of course you can go to his Instagram at Austin_Buchanan. That's BUCHANAN. I know how to spell it, and I'll never say it wrong again. you can go to his website, is austinbuchanan.com, and check out that. I think you'll enjoy that. By all means, follow him on Instagram. One last question I want to ask you is that... do you think, well, going forward in your career, is there something that you haven't done yet in this industry that you would like to do? Director, cinematographer, props, craft services?
Oh, man, that's hard.
Yeah, there you go. I didn't say it was going to be easy.
Or are honestly, you happy? I would like...
You can be I mean, happy.
I would just like to be working more like any other actor.
Yeah.
That's, I think I would love to do this all of the time.
Yeah.
Every day, 24 hours. Maybe like a reoccurring role on a TV show.
A series.
That would be great. Yeah.
Yeah.
Something where I have time to shape my character and build and just have that reference.
Sure.
That is definitely something that I haven't done.
When you say that, it comes to my mind that people always say to me, they go, man, you do so many things. And I go, yeah, I do so many things, but it would be nice to do one thing and make a living off of it.
Yeah.
And, you know, so is that, I guess, do I speak the same sentiments to you? Is that as an actor, we have so many things that we have to do to really, in essence, make a living, but in essence, also to keep fulfilling our dream. Do you have lots of, I know you do, you have lots and lots of things you do, and would it be nice to be on a series purely just to be able to go, I'm going to go walk on set, I'm going to be on set, I'm going to sit in my makeup table, I'm going to do my thing, and my job is going to be done, and, you know, when I leave, I'll be prepared for the next day, but would that be fun?
Yes, 100%. I don't mind doing the freelance lifestyle right now.
Yeah.
My hand is in everything, which is great,
yeah.
Especially in a town like Tucson, where it's like the biggest small town you'll ever be in.
Yes.
And everybody knows you and this and that. Mm-hmm. But yeah, just to be able to say, oh, I do this.
Yeah. That's
it. And that's it. Like, yeah. That would be fantastic. If acting could, honestly, so I don't wish to be famous. That's not really the goal. I just wish I could do this.
Working.
Yeah, I could provide for myself and the people I love while acting full time.
There it is.
That's it.
Austin Buchanan, one of our winners on AllCasting and AllCasting.com. Thanks for coming on the show. Awesome. Great talking to you.
It was great talking to you. Thank you. Yeah,
and by the way, we'll also follow up with the information below. You can see on the acting studio he works at. They're doing some amazing stuff. I highly recommend if you're in the Tucson area or if there's any kind of satellite stuff they're doing, whatever. I recommend you do it because finding an organization like they have out there and their a family community is kind of rare that you all give such a depth of the industry. So thanks for doing that as well.
Of course, yeah. Anything I can do to give back.
Absolutely. Hey, Will Roberts here, of course, allcasting.com and actingupradio.com. That's this segment. We're going to take a small break, and when we come back, I'm going to bring in another guest, so don't go away. Come on back.